Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the first two part of the flip-flop conversion, we have seen that how to convert the SR and the JK flip-flops into the other flip-flops. So similarly, in this video, let us understand that how to convert the D flip-flop into the JK, SR as well as the T flip-flop. So in the first two parts, we have seen that during the conversion, we need to design the combinational circuit in such a way that we can convert the one flip-flop into the other flip-flop. And for that, we have also seen the different steps which we need to follow during the conversion. So by following these steps, now let us convert the D flip-flop into the SR flip-flop. So here, since the SR flip-flop is our required flip-flop, so first of all, let us write down the truth table of the SR flip-flop. So as you know, for the SR flip-flop, when both inputs S and R are 0, then the flip-flop will retain its current state. Similarly, when the S is 0 and R is 1, then the flip-flop will get reset to 0. Similarly, when S is 1 and R is 0, then irrespective of the present state of the flip-flop, in the next state, the output of the flip-flop will become 1. And likewise, when both S and R inputs are 1, then the output of the flip-flop is indeterminate. So for the last two conditions, it doesn't matter what is the value of the D input. And therefore, for the last two conditions, this D input is the don't care term. But apart from that, to find all these output transitions, let us see what should be the value of the D input. And for that, we will take the help of the excitation table of the D flip-flop. So as you know, for the D flip-flop, the output is same as the input. So if you want 0 as the output, then this D input should also be equal to 0. And likewise, if you want 1 as the output, then this D input should also be equal to 1. So this is the excitation table of the D flip-flop. So using this, we can easily complete this table. So as you can see from the excitation table, to get this output as 0, this D input should be equal to 0. And similarly, to get the output as 1, this D input should be equal to 1. And likewise, we can complete entire table. So now, once we got this table, then let us find the expression of the D in terms of the S, R and the Qn. Because once we get this relation, then we can easily design the combinational circuit which is required for the conversion. So if we notice over here, then this D input is 1 for the 3 different input combinations. That is 001, 100 and 101. And if you see the corresponding minterms, then they are M1, M4 and M5. But apart from that, here we also have two don't care terms, that is 110 and 111. And the corresponding minterms are M6 and M7. So now, let us write down all these minterms in the K map. And let us try to find the simplified expression of the D. So here, all the minterms are represented in the K map. So now if you observe, then with the help of the don't care term, we can make the group of these four minterms. And similarly, to cover this minterm M1, we can make the group of this M1 and M5. So here, this group corresponds to S. And similarly, the second group corresponds to R dash dot Qn. Because in that group, the value of R and Qn is not changing. So if you see the value of R, then it is equal to 0, while the value of Qn is equal to 1. Therefore, this group corresponds to R dash dot Qn. And the expression of the D is the summation of these two terms. That means D is equal to S plus R dash dot Qn. And this is how we can design the corresponding circuit. So as you can see, with the help of the one NOT gate, we can get this R dash. And using this AND gate, we will get this R dash dot Qn. So once we get this term, then with the help of the OR gate, we can get this expression. So in this way, we can convert this D flip-flop into the SR flip-flop. So similarly, now let us see how to convert the D flip-flop into the JK flip-flop. So here, since the JK flip-flop is our required flip-flop, so first of all, let us write down the truth table of the JK flip-flop. So as you know, for the JK flip-flop, when its both inputs are 0, then it will retain its current state. Similarly, when this J is 0 and K is 1, then the flip-flop will get reset to 0. Likewise, when this J is 1 and K is 0, then the flip-flop will get set to 1. And likewise, when both J and K inputs are 1, then the output of the flip-flop will toggle. That means presently, if this Qn is 0, then in the next state it will become 1. And likewise, when this Qn is 1, then in the next state it will become 0. So that is the truth table of the JK flip-flop. So now, to get all these output transitions, let us find the required value of the D input. And once again, to find the required value of the D input, we will take the help of the excitation table. So as you can see from the excitation table, if you want the 0 as the output, then the required D input is also equal to 0. And likewise, if you want the 1 as the output, then the required D input is also equal to 1. So in this way, we can complete the entire table. So now, let us find the expression of the D in terms of the JK and the QN. So if you notice the column of the D, then it is equal to 1 for the 4 different input combinations. That is 001, 100, 101 and 110. And if you see the corresponding minterms, then they are M1, M4, M5 and M6. So now, let us write down all these minterms in the K-map and let us try to find the simplified expression of the D. So here, all the 4 minterms are represented in the K-map. So if you observe over here, then with the help of the minterm M1 and M5, we can make the group of 2 ones. Similarly, with the help of the minterm 4 and 5, we can make the group of 2 ones. And by making these 2 groups, we are able to cover all the minterms in the K-map. So here, this group corresponds to J.Qn bar, because in this group, the value of variable J and Qn is not changing. So in this group, the value of variable J is equal to 1, while the value of variable Qn is equal to 0. And therefore, this group corresponds to J.Qn bar. Similarly, this group corresponds to K.Qn, because in this group, the value of variable K is equal to 0, while the value of variable Qn is equal to 1. So if you see the overall expression of the D, then it is the summation of these 2 terms. That means the D is equal to J.Qn bar plus K.Qn. And this is how we can convert the D flip-flop into the JK flip-flop. So as you can see, with the help of the 1 NOT gate and the 1 AND gate, we got the expression K.Qn. And similarly, with the help of this AND gate, we will get the term J.Qn bar. And as you can see, with the help of the OR gate, we can perform the logical OR operation of these 2 terms. So in this way, we can convert the D flip-flop into the JK flip-flop. So similarly, now let us see how to convert the D flip-flop into the T flip-flop. So here, since the T flip-flop is our required flip-flop, so first of all, let us write down the truth table of the T flip-flop. So as we know, for the T flip-flop, when the input is equal to 0, then the flip-flop will retain its current state. And whenever this T input is 1, then the output of the flip-flop will toggle. That means currently, if this Qn is 0, then in the next state it will become 1. And likewise, currently if the Qn is 1, then in the next state it will become 0. So that is the truth table of the T flip-flop. So now, to get all these output transitions, let us find the required value of the D input. And once again, to find this value, we will take the help of the excitation table of the D flip-flop. So as you can see from the excitation table, the required value of the D input is same as the output. That means whenever this Qn plus 1 is 0, then the required value of the D input is also equal to 0. And whenever this Qn plus 1 is equal to 1, then the required value of the D input is also equal to 1. So in this way, we can complete entire table. So now, let us find the expression of the D in terms of the T and Qn. So if you notice over here, then this D input is 1 for the 2 different input combinations, that is 01 and 10. And if you see the corresponding minterms, then they are M1 and M2. So we can say that this D is equal to this T.Qn plus T.Qn bar. Or we can say that this D is equal to TXOQn. That means simply using the 1 XOR gate, we can convert this D flip-flop into the T flip-flop. So in this way, we have seen that how to convert the D flip-flop into the JK, SR as well as the T flip-flop. So similarly, in the next part of the video, we will see that how to convert the T flip-flop into SRD as well as the JK flip-flop. So if you have any questions or suggestions, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.